Digital empowerment. Nowadays, mobile internet has been spread over all the citizens. Everybody can use internet and get many information as he want.
As we know, at this pandemic era, the value of digitalization and our government also working in digital empowerment of our citizens. So in July 2015, our Indian government launched a program Digital India to digitalize our country. The aim of this program is to connect with internet to every part of our country. And mobile smartphone and mobile internet plays an important part to connectivity of internet in our country. And number of e-transactions and is also increased in this era. As we can all know that in this period everything is shut down. So many works are done by internet on their smartphones and laptops, like schools and office meetups and everything. So our government also working day by day to digital improvise to our citizens.
We are living in the 21st century, and we are living in 21st century, and there is no doubt this is a digital century. And India's ranking is not good in digitalization. To improve this ranking, our Prime Minister started this Digital India program as well in 2015. And after this program, there is many successful deals as India's ranking in 2014 higher and in 2016 it is very changing. To improve this, there are many factors to change the digitalization. As you can start online classes and online transaction, etc. There are many, because the digitalization changed the standard of the world.
Today our topic of discussion was that Digital India and how far was it success. So we can see the success of the program by nowadays it is a pandemic era, and we have seen we cannot go out. And so many of the works are completed with the help of internet, and it helped. The government sites are connected electronically, and we can fill the form. We can do many works by sitting at home, and many people who have left their jobs can do freelancing. There are many websites like Freelancer and many other websites. They can earn their daily needs and from the internet. It has helped us in many other ways, it has increased the education system it has increased the education level up to a very good position.
So Digital India scheme was launched in 2015 by Indian governments, and we know that there are many advantages of digital world, but still there are some disadvantages in the digital world. We can say that many advantage, we can access any information from the internet if we want to do something, and it is the basic need of the citizen nowadays, internet. And still some advantage hacking, and a person who is unauthorized can access all the information of the government. That is very harmful.
As you also know very well, the main aim of this program is high-speed internet for every common man. I think that to success this aim, a big role is Jio Digital company launched in 2017. To this company, they provide us low-rate internet, and many talented and many politicians and teachers create their ID in YouTube and make their videos. Due to these videos, we are motivated and enjoy, and they earn lot of money. It is very good for us.
Airtel was the first who launched 4G in the India, and we know that Airtel provides a good facility, and Jio also. So we can say that there are many sources by which we can access the internet. So I want to say that internet is the basic need nowadays.
if I talk about India's position in digitalization, so is not good. But now, since our Prime Minister launched Digital India on July 2015, now it's increased day by day. And the main aim of this Digital India is to provide high-speed internet to every citizen and e-governance and digitalization in every sectors of jobs.
So that now we are suffering from COVID-19 and internet has become a supportive for us, all of us in the, if we can say it help us in study and entertainment also. While we were lying down in our houses, that internet was the better option to make easier our life. And if we talk about the students that who were at home due to the COVID-19, that schools were closed, they helped to continue their study through internet, and it was a better step taken by our government to digitalize our environment so that we could prefer a good life.
So friends, there are a number of benefits of digitalization in India. First is availability of high speed internet to everyone. Second is electronic transaction, which is also an important thing. And third is the main advantage of the internet is the connectivity. People from anywhere can connect with anyone with the help of internet. And the disadvantage of this is the cyber crime. If the digitalization will become completely, the cyber crime will also increase. Like hacking and fake transactions.
Digitalization has played an important role in many fields as education and doctor field. You can consult each and a doctor anytime. And this is the result that the India's ranking in digitalization of health criteria is number one. There is no country that completed digitalization the health criteria, but India do this. And this is the result of the digitalization India program.
Increased rapidly. It provided a lot of facilities like e-governance, e-health, and digital locus. Digital locus provide that we secure our documents like passport and documents other than
that. I agree with my friend, number two. Because he is saying India, the number of internet users is increased day by day. And I think the increasing of internet users may play a role Jio, because Jio provide internet in a low fees.
I think it is very innovative campaign to transform our country into a digital technology. And it is also removes the gap between the rural and also in the urban areas. And it will help us to upgrade the weaker society into a developed society, and it will help the connectivity. It will help the people in India to connect each other. And also the second thing is that during this COVID-19 pandemic, it play very important role, because our children of India are not able to go to school and their study is stopped, and it help us to them for study. Thank you.
India is on the position of 98 position. So we can say that India is improving day by day digital world. So digital world play an important role in agriculture, private office, government sector, my friends you know that we have drawn
like a problem like as corruption and illiteracy etc. So it is a most advanced beneficial method to reduce illiteracy and corruption method. Through the e-banking we have to reduce the corruption method and we can transaction in a few seconds and we can save our times and also we can save our money. And through this method we have to pay our tax to government because many people they cannot submit their money in banking and they are unable to pay their government taxes. And this through this method it reduces these things and it also monetizes other things. And in other way we will say that it also really helps in education method and mostly people go to through online education and many apps are launched by the government due to which we can take our online education and other method also in use in agriculture field. Government provide many facilities then in Argo farmer application are launched by the government in which they can check the infrastructure of the agriculture and they can check the money and they can check the balance of the our crops and they can save and they can sell the our crops to the
achieving connectivity in our country. Mobile internet plays a vital role to activity of digitalization in our country. For by using of mobile internet we can get facilities like schooling, e-banking, online transaction and e-governance and many papers and documents of government are also being made and supplied by internet. As we can see the farmers of our area are sugarcane farmers. When they get the whole list of their means purchase on their by their app on their phone.
As we have focused upon the brighter side of the topic, like advantages of the internet, but the topic was Digital India and how far was its success. So it has failed in many ways and drastically it has failed. Like first Jio company, as my friend said, and I don't know which one said, the Jio company launched internet in a, like when it launched the internet it was free. They gave us it for free for 1 year. Then after that they increased the plans to $3.99 and now we are more depending upon the internet. And like where we do not play the first, like in villages they used to play cricket, but now it has reduced. Now four persons will sit in a room and they will be busy in their own phone, nobody talks, nobody is talking, and due to which we are lacking behind in many ways, the physical like eyes and many other physical disadvantages. And also like they are increasing now plans, now like it has currently it is $6.99 and they will keep on increasing. Like they are depending and we are buying. First like when internet was so costly, then it was like 250 in 1 GB, 1 GB was for 250, but now it has increased and they will be keep on increasing. The due to this we are depending
on. I have not
expected
2015 and 16 the price of 1 GB is around 300.
Okay.
But today in 200 per month we can get a GB one per day. Jio bring a internet revolution in our country.
But what about the health? We are losing every day.
How can we improve health by Digital India?
Wasn't the life before 2018 and
2019.
I want to say that it depends on us. What we are, how much time we spend on the internet. There is no health issue. We can say still there are many advantages of digital world. We can say we can do many transactions online like PhonePe, Google Pay. There are many resources by which we can do transaction at home.
A statement by Chash number 10. In India, there is a good proportion who are digitally illiterate. They don't know how to use it. And even in most of the villages, there is no availability of the internet, so how they use the Digital India? It is success if each and every citizen gets benefit of that.
Yeah, I want to say that a person who is not able to access internet, they can use LAN or WAN technology, by which in local area network, they can use LAN, and in the wide area, they can use WAN.
Yes, I agree with my guest that we are lacking in the physical activities due to this Digital India, but still I believe that it is very beneficial because Now we don't have to stand in the lines of the banks for many hours to submit or to receive our money. And also it is very good for agriculture because farmers, the government provide e-ganna app to the farmers, which is very beneficial for the farmers also.
Starting from 5 years, this program cannot achieve our 100%. This is the reason that in many rural villages, people cannot aware about the digitalization. If government starts some program to digitalization, program to awareness of people of the villagers to achieve this, because they realize that this is a safe and easy program to this, and they may realize it.
Our Prime Minister Narendra Modi changed the currency. Then digital world play a very important role. We are not able to go in bank. Directly we cannot collect our cash. Then e-banking play a very important role to transaction for the things.
That we need. Yes, I agree, my friend. Nowadays we are facing a pandemic. So we can use internet access on the internet banking, and we cannot go to the colleges, school. So we can teach and read through the internet access.
Through internet, it has reduced the paper load work. That for if we go for a job and anything, we have to took a lot of papers with us, and so it was difficult to carry out it. But it has become easier for us to that we can through laptop, cell phones, we can make it easier. And so smartphones have become cheaper and cheaper, so that everyone citizen in India can get access to internet and have a good knowledge about this. Through internet we also can get good knowledge, and we can also entertain ourselves. It depends on us that how can we use it. There are many lots of advantages of internet, so it depends on us how we treat with it.
Excuse me. Stop. Time is over. I told you, if someone is speaking, you should not speak. You should not interrupt that person. You have the problem. You have to change it, okay? You know, यदि आप बोलने लगे अब फिर कोई बोल रहा है तो फिर तो रुको मत. बट अगर कोई बोल रहा है तुम भी बोलने लगे वहां वो कोई नहीं कहेंगे आपको रुकने को, पर आपका नेगेटिव पॉइंट हो जाए. थोड़ा वो ध्यान रखिए, थोड़ा आप पेशेंस रखो, होगा. लेकिन प्लीज रिमेंबर वन थिंग, इफ समवन इज स्पीकिंग यू शुड नॉट स्पीक. एंड आई टोल्ड यू, इफ यू हैव टू स्टॉप समवन से टू एक्सक्यूज मी, देन ही विल फॉर अ मोमेंट ही विल स्टॉप, देन ही विल स्टार्ट टू स्पीक. But you should not speak if someone is speaking. Okay, Khair, that was nice discussion.